Today, we will be looking at performing batch runs on a quarter car suspension. The model contains the vehicle mass, suspension stiffness and damping, wheel mass, and tire stiffness. We begin by selecting Configure to open the study parameters. Here, we may define which model parameters we wish to perform a study on. Our focus will be on the vehicle mass. By selecting Study, we can produce a batch analysis which varies the mass between runs. Here, we varied the mass in increments of 10 kilograms, going from 350 to 410. The model can be run directly from this window. Now, progress for all 7 runs can be viewed in the run monitor below. By plotting car mass, we are able to view the results of all 7 runs by selecting the results set in the plot window. Now, all 7 states of the model are automatically detected, and we can view them all overlaid on the same graph. Here we can see the displacement of each iteration for the vehicle mass. By selecting now post-processing, we can look at more detail. This will open the post-processing window, and here we're able to create new variables, which are expressions of the basic simulation outputs. By opening the expression editor, we can create expressions of those simulation outputs using logical operators and other functions. Here, we'll be using the local minimum with truncation to view the lower displacement limit of the vehicle. We can begin typing any variable we wish and will automatically be identified within the simulation variables. Now, we can select cross results, which will open next to the post-processing window. By selecting the cross results window, we're able to cross-reference results against each other or by simulation run. Here we can select any output, such as vehicle mass, from this list. We can also include the post-processing variable which we have just created. By default, these are compared against each simulation batch run, as denoted by the asterisk. But we are able to explicitly type the simulation runs we want to display by modifying the value in x-axis. So by typing in runs 1 through 6 inclusively, we can instead show only the first 6 simulation runs in our cross-referencing. Now when we plot these variables, we can see the value across each simulation run and even select the graph type we want by right-clicking on the graph. By plotting these 2 cross results together and modifying the graph, we are able to more concretely define the relationship between vehicle mass and the lower displacement limit in a single piece of information. We're even able to convert the axis values to have one trend line which gives us the relationship between lower displacement limit and vehicle mass. This customized graph is also able to be saved to the model for later reuse. And that is batch runs in Simcenter Amesim. Thank you.